Hi everyone, in this video we are going to discuss why main method in Java is public static void. So first of all, we'll see why do we need main method. Well, while creating our first Java program, right, we create a class, we create a main method, and inside it we write a statement called system.out.println hello world, right? Now the question is, why do we need to create that main method, right? So we all know that JVM is responsible for execution of a Java program. And for that, there has to be some starting point, right? So this main method is the starting point of execution for JVM. So that's the reason we create the main method. Now let us see the syntax of it. So the signature of main method is public static void main. So you might have seen this. We always write this as is. The signature of the main method will always be like this, right? So now let us understand these keywords one by one. What do they mean? So the first one is public. Public is an access modifier, meaning from where and who can access this method is set by this access modifier. And when we actually have our main method as public as an access modifier, then this method is globally available, and JVM can invoke this method from outside the class as well. That's the reason we have a main method as public. Next comes static. So whenever we write a method and have this method before the method, when we write static keyword, right? So that means we don't need to create an object for that class in which the method is present. We can directly call this method without creating an object for that class in which the method is present. So what happens here is, so why we have main method as static is so that JVM can invoke without instantiating the class, that is without creating an object of that class. We also have another advantage of this. So when we have a main method as static, so memory is saved. We don't need to create an object. That's how we actually save some memory in the heap. So it doesn't make sense to create an object just for calling the main method, right? So so that's the reason main method is static, so that without instantiating the class, we can actually call the main method. Next comes void. Void is a return type. So any method should have a return type, and we need to specify what that method returns. And if any method is returning nothing, then we have the return type as void. Now, why do we have main method as void, return type of main method as void, right? So as soon as main method terminates, right? So Java program also terminates. So it doesn't make sense to actually return something in the main method, as JVM cannot do anything as the program is already terminated. Next comes main. So you can see here the default signature, which is predefined in the JVM. JVM looks for this signature, whether it is present or not, so that it can actually start the execution from that point. So it is an identifier which actually JVM looks, right, for the starting point of the execution. And remember, it's not a keyword. Main is not a keyword. Rest of them, whichever we discussed till now, public, static, void, all of these are keywords. Well, what is a keyword? Keyword is a reserved word in Java. So we can't use these keywords as your variable names, method names, class name, etc. So main here is not a keyword. And this main method accepts one parameter, array of strings, which is a command line arguments. And the name of this parameter, right? This string array parameter, args, this is not fixed. We can have the name of our choice here. So this is about the signature of main method. Now let us see the different ways of writing the main method. I have a class here. I create main method. You can see the signature here, public static void main, string args, right? It is an array of strings. Now let me print something on the console, some welcome, right? Let us execute this program. So it actually prints welcome, right? All right. Now, here we have this square braces, right? Representing an array. We can have this at the end of the parameter as well. This is one way of writing we can see the output. So there is no issue with that. We can even have the square braces before the parameter name as well. And also this public static are the two keywords, right? So these are interchangeable. So I can have static first and have this access modifier after that. This is also a valid syntax. So you can see the output here. So in this video, these are the different, actually these are the different ways of writing the main method. So in this video, we discussed in detail about the signature of the main method. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.